So everybody knows Disney bought the Star Wars, the rights to Star Wars, the entire expanded universe, the whole thing from George Lucas. And starting in 2015, they're going to be making a film every summer, and it's going to be the trilogy, 7, 8, and 9, every other year, with little one-character spin-offs after that. And I'm very excited about this, but I have to say, part of me is a little sort of taken back by that. Just everything, this feels so corporate. What once was something so special to me, and he fought the system and, you know, created something so brilliant and this whole world, and now it's just Disney giant machine. Is this just the way everything just ends up being?
Well, I have three things to say. One, my husband started his writing film career because he saw Star Wars and he was so inspired. Secondly, I don't know the difference between Star Trek and Star Wars.
So. Neither does President Obama.
No, I mean, I really do, but I really, I don't. I couldn't. And the third is, I once, when I was a little girl, I watched a movie called The Long Weekend, The Lost Weekend. And in the middle of the movie, they came on and they said, we put the second reel on first by accident. And like, I watched this whole, I mean, it was unheard of, right? And they played the whole thing again, like they started it from the beginning. That's how I feel with Star Wars. It's like, I don't know, did it start the first time? Like, it's very confusing.
There's
to me.
Right, if you're not a sci-fi person, it can be very confusing. What do you think? Well, is this just sad that everything just goes so corporate? And even that they've laid it out this way, like for the next 6 years, every summer, we're going to make you,
and the spin-off. Enough is enough.
And at the same time, Disney laid off like 150 people that worked at LucasArts that was creating all the video games for Star Wars.
Okay, first, I have never seen a single Star Wars movie. No, nothing. So if you want me to stop, I will.
But well, we may have to stop the show now, but
that being
not
said,
the booker I will have to talk to.
I agree with you, though, because I knew that there were, what, three to begin with, and then they were like, this is the prequel, and I was like, oh, because this happened, who, what? And that's why I'm not really interested in it very much. I think also because I hadn't seen it when I was young, so I just didn't care.
Okay.
But you're a big...
Almost everything I believe is built on something from the Star Wars universe. So you know what, let's take this a little back from Star Wars itself and focus on the idea that, can we do anything original anymore?
Well,
like the fact that they're rebooting it, go ahead.
It's like, in a way, to me, it seems like something that is a cult classic, something that you enjoy, and you're clearly not alone, it becomes more like the Scary Movie franchise, where it just gets more ridiculous when it's like Scary Movie 13, and you're like, oh, is this part of the spinoff? Are they gonna bring that character back too? Because it's just almost like a joke after a while.
Yeah, but the corporate end of it, that's the part that scares me, that we just keep, instead of coming up with original thoughts, you could, you know, there's some kid that's 15 right now writing some amazingly brilliant thing that'll probably never get produced because the, you know, the corporations will just, you know, can we spin off?
Marvel and big blockbuster.
Right.
Now, when you go, do you go to the movies?
Or
okay, so you don't rent it at
I
all.
I dressed up for Revenge of the Sith.
Okay,
I've never said
I
that
have
on.
To go.
Yeah, I've never
Revenge
said that
on. Revenge of the Sith.
That was no the
idea.
Sixth. And, oh, Lord. Lordy,
it's
Lordy.
It's the sixth, but it's Friday on Tuesday.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So is it just naive of me? Am I just a wild thinker to believe that maybe corporate America won't infect every...
It does, though. Think about Broadway. There is no original thing on Broadway. It's all movies being adapted for
movies
the...
Movies and theme park rides.
And theme park rides. They're being adapted for the stage. It's like, you're right, there's a kid somewhere who has a great musical idea that is never going to be able to push it through without Weinstein behind it.
So what is that about us? Why is that? We all, if you were to ask anybody, they would say, oh, I want something original, I want something fresh,
like
Honey
Boo Boo. You can identify with it. You've seen The Little Mermaid.
You know what to expect.
Right.
When I lived in New York and my parents came to visit, they wanted to see something like The Little Mermaid because they knew how the story ended. They knew what to look for and what to wait for.
They weren't going to waste their money on something that was, ooh, maybe it's...
We're lazy. We're lazy people.
Right. I guess it's why people come to New York City and go to the Olive Garden in Times Square
we're
instead
lazy.
Of, you know...
We're there lazy. Us three,
Applebee's.
We are not.
Applebee's.
Well, Disney, I will be still paying to go to all the Star Wars movies, and I'm going to drag Wendy and M. Paul.
I'm not dressing up.
I'm not
maybe with the hair.
Oh, and who had that hair? Come on. Carrie Fisher, who played?
Princess Leia.
Look at this. All right, we did something. Bonobos.com is the official outfitter of the Rubin Report. Use code TRR20 for 20% off your first purchase.